Happy Wednesday to you, fanatics. I'm Chris Williams here, going to talk a little Iowa State basketball. Today's video blog. This blog is brought to us by Planet Sub. Actually, I'm getting ready to go write my mailbag column right now that we do every week at Psycho and Fanatic. Somebody in there wrote, "Hey, Chris, what should I get at Planet Sub? What's your favorite sub?" Absolutely no question. If you're having problems picking from all the great selections, go with the buffalo chicken. It's become a staple in my diet. I'm sure you can tell. It is absolutely wonderful. Go with the buffalo chicken if you're a chicken fan. Really spicy, really good. Dip it in a little ranch. It's a perfect treat before you go out to Hilton Coliseum tonight to watch the Cyclones take on Northern Iowa. Now, on Monday in his press conference, Greg McDermott referred to the Northern Iowa Panthers as the best team Iowa State has played thus far. That's saying quite a bit now, Coach, after Northwestern last night. Don't know if you saw this, Cyclone fans, but they beat up on NC State in Raleigh. This Northwestern team is red hot with wins over Notre Dame, Iowa State, NC State. All of a sudden, that loss isn't looking so bad. Now, don't blame me for being a little bit upset. I mean, that's a game Iowa State should have won. I think Iowa State was the better basketball team of the two. But, no, I don't think anybody expected the Cyclones to go undefeated. At the beginning of the season, I had them pegged at 6-1. Granted, I had them losing to Notre Dame instead of Northwestern, but I don't think that loss is the end of the world. Actually, I got this bit of knowledge from my father, believe it or not. He kind of compared the Northwestern basketball team to going head-to-head with the wishbone offense in football, except in football you got 6 days to prepare for an offense. In basketball, in this specific situation, no time at all, and that really threw a curveball to Iowa State. They didn't lose that game because of offensive. Yeah, they could have shot better. Craig could have finished those plays in the second half. That's not why they lost, though, in my opinion. They lost because of simple defensive breakdowns that came with guarding that Northwestern offense. And let's hope everything is cleared up for tonight, because you have a very good Northern Iowa basketball team coming into town, very familiar with Coach McDermott and his system. Now, last year in Cedar Falls, we saw Craig Brackett go off on the Panthers. He had a huge game, one of his biggest games of the season. Here's the good news. Craig doesn't have to do that tonight. He has so many more pieces around him. I anticipate Iowa State to come out here and shoot the ball very well this evening in Hilton Coliseum. This team having two off nights in a row is pretty rare. They've had two off nights in a row. Having three off nights in a row, I don't think it's going to happen. I think Iowa comes out, they shoot the three ball well. I think Craig gets his 20. I think Marquez Gilstrap gets his 20 tonight. Yeah, I think the big guys are going to have a big night for Iowa State. In the end, it might all come down to point guard play, Deontay Garrett, but he's been very sharp so far in 2009. It's a very well-coached Northern Iowa basketball team. It's a very experienced Northern Iowa basketball team. Don't expect them to get frazzled by Hilton Coliseum and the Cyclone Alley that's going to be out in full force this evening. This is a very savvy Northern Iowa team coming to town. I anticipate a very, very good basketball game. I'm going to take the Cyclones by a final of 73-65. Clones get a few cheap free throws right at the end and stretch it out to that big of a margin. One more thing before I go, gotta throw this out there. I think Paul Rhoads absolutely got jobbed with the Big 12 Coach of the Year ballots that were released yesterday, or the results that were released. Come on, Mack Brown, I understand that he's a great coach, okay? Can't take anything away from what he's done at Texas this year, but he's at Texas. The guy has tools that Paul Rhoads probably doesn't even know exists at this point in time. Look at Iowa State's defense last year, if you have any game tape. Look at them now. The strides that this team has made in 1 year is unbelievable. It's not because there's better talent on the field. It's because they've been coached from a team that lost 19 games in 2 years to a team that's going to a bowl game here in just a few weeks. Paul Rhoads should have been the Coach of the Year. To me, that is an absolute joke, giving that award to Mack Brown. Just my thoughts today on my vlog. Again, this vlog brought to us by Planet Sub. Go out and get yourself a buffalo chicken before the ball game tonight. I have a feeling I might do that near campus town in Ames. Thanks a lot for watching. For CycloneFanatic.com, I'm Chris Williams.